Hello. Okay, a falling robot may not be the best start for a video, I get that. But this is not going to be about, you know, how to damage one of those, it's more like how to improve it. And anyway, the robot is just fine, both of them, there were more crashes. So, my name is Maciej Kubička, and I'm going to talk about wireless communications between a number of NXT robots like those in here. Up until now, as far as I know, there was no such functionality in a Crobot toolbox. While it would open door to a whole new set of problems which could be modeled, solved and tested in reality with help of Simulink. For example, there are problems related to distributed computations, there are problems related to player-based games, and maybe even playing football for what I know. It's all possible with the upgrade I'm going to show you. So.
It's based on this radio frequency module called XB. The dongle on right allows connection to NXT computer via differential bus, and there is designated driver for XB inside the NXT computer. I wrote it in C and integrated with its operating system in a way that its routines are available on its application interface. So essentially you can write just any application you want on this operating system with the XB driver. Well, as you can see, there are only three routines required for communication: receive, send and setup. Since the wireless network is routing messages between a number of different devices, each device has unique address. You need to specify this address in those functions in order to send or receive a message. Now, when we have hardware with functioning driver, we need to tell Simulink how to simulate such network and how to generate proper codes to it. For those purposes, I have designed a level 2S function which handles message routing and delivery. It expands into 5 masked blocks added into Acrobot toolbox: send, receive, setup and reception and transmission gates. Those last two gates are similar with their functionality to all those interface kind of blocks in Acrobot block set. They simply interface controllers, nothing else, they are only and only for simulation. In addition to my S function, I also utilize a TrueTime toolbox from Lund University in Sweden. It can simulate physical properties of wireless networks, so it allows simulated transmissions to be as realistic as possible. My S function also supports full code generation. There is this target language compiler script which does that, and it ensures together with TrueTime toolbox that the robot behaves the same in both reality and simulation. Now, let's look at example. What I have here is extension to a popular demo called NXTAV-AGS. It's two-wheeled balancing robot and I have extended it to two remotely controlled balancing robots. Here we can see the big picture. The two robots connected via TrueTime network and the command generator connected to the first robot via Bluetooth. Now, let's look to the controllers inside those robots. As we can see, the gates are used to connect controller to its simulated environment. Nothing particularly interesting about that in here. We only need to set up addresses of sender and receiver. It's kind of similar to Bluetooth interface blocks, which are above. Now, in the initialization task, we call XB setup function. It does initialization during startup and so we can receive and send data within regular tasks later. And finally, in the updating task, we receive data over Bluetooth, we process it and directly send its part to other robot. The other robot receives the data and uses it as a reference for regulation. So, at the end I'm going to show you how this module works in simulation and in practice. You are looking at simulation output of the model I've just described. You can observe that both robots have their own route, hence the XB communication is working.